Welcome everyone to a video. Today I'm going to show beginners how you could earn money. You see all these crates, you want to build stuff, build a big boat, right? You're working with limited materials and I will show you exactly how you could get those money. Now for all you beginners out there to make money that's pretty efficient are these quests. Now to do them, they give you a decent amount of money for a new player. You will need it because you want to get some blocks. The more blocks you get, the better boat you can build, the better boat you get, the farther you will get along in those stages. So it's a pretty simple cycle, and once you get enough into the game itself, you could start building glitch machines like those ones on YouTube. But those glitch machines require material, so I won't include glitch machines in this video simply because you need to be somewhat into the game to have those set materials. And so my plan is to build out a little bit here, delete the bottom so the thing will actually tilt forward and hopefully hit the target. And let's see if I could actually do pull this off. No, and I have to be higher than the target itself, so when the thing tilts, it goes down, you know. And let me just stand on the edge of this. Let me delete the bottom. Okay, in theory, if you put a chair, it's going to tilt you forward, but I forgot, I'm an idiot. So next time you should probably put a chair. It's going to fling you forward and get the target. So pretty simple way of earning money. This one, I'm actually going to show a glitch machine, but it's realistically simple. So a noob could probably build it. It doesn't require that much material. So just follow what I do. You could be on any team if you want. So first of all, you want to place down a stool, then get a cake, assuming you have one, and you want to get a piece of hinge. The hinge could be bought in the shop for 50 gold right over here, so just save up for it if you want. And now what you want to do is you want to make sure the hinge, the yellow part of the hinge, is on top of the cake, so it's one tile above the cake, it's not equal. Then you want to delete the chair, make sure the anchor block is not anchored, or else you might have to redo again. You will have to turn on the shift lock mode. It's over here. Go press escape, go to settings, go to shift lock. Make sure it's on. After it's on, you want to press W to climb upwards. Then after you climb up like this, you want to press space so you can start flying. Oh, and a trick for this glitch is if you swing your camera around, you will actually go a little bit faster. So just make sure you take advantage of the speed right here. You see, this is slow if you don't swing, but if you do swing, you could actually go a little bit faster. So good trick to help you grind along the way. Oh, and make sure you actually zoom out a little bit so you don't hit any obstacles. For example, the crystal stage and whatnot. I believe this is uncollidable, so this stage wouldn't affect me anyways. Let me just do the swing thing so I could get fast. And now, look, we're on the last stage already. So pretty simple trick. Also, you don't need to press launch or anything. When you get to the end, you could either press S to climb down. Like over here, you would have to press S to climb down so you don't get stuck on this wall over here. After you climb down a little bit, just fly to the treasure thing and you will get the gold. Well, when you get over here, you don't need to press S, just undo your shift lock thing, delete your hinge, and just get the treasure chest easily like this. So realistically, for a beginner, if you have a cake, I think that's the hardest thing you would have to obtain. But if you do have one, it's pretty easy and it's pretty OP. You want to be on the magenta team or the yellow team, so you could just go over here and just switch teams. Yeah, that's yellow team. Alright, so now that we're at a yellow team, let's start building. So assuming that you don't have metal or all that fancy material and all that whatnot, so I'm going to use some simpler parts here. Just get a chair like this. And what you want to do is you want to place a lot of blocks inside you, so you could save space and stuff. So I'm gonna use concrete because I think that's what most people actually have. I just put some stuff here. Try to put it inside you if you can, like this. Stack up a little bit and do this. Cover yourself in concrete because this is basically body armor. Now you don't have to build an actual interior for your boat. Just build a concrete core like this. And let me just make this a square and done. Thing you want to do is spam whatever other blocks you have, because when you open chests you get a lot of random stuff, I assume. Make sure you also armor the bottom as well. The point is to not make the boat too wide, because if you're wide you're going to hit more obstacles on average than a boat that's narrow. So I picked the yellow team or the magenta team because how close it is to the waterfall, so you won't have to spend as much time sailing through useless parts of the water and get to the gold grinding part straight away. How the game calculates how you get gold is on the right side. You could see all the stages. So every time you pass a block wall, which is a divider in here, you're going to get a little bit of gold, plus 8 if you're a team leader, plus 10 if you're a member. So if you're not a team leader, you would actually get a little bit more gold, but I'm not sure about that fact. I found it on the wiki, so yeah. And you see we passed the first stage, and we're going to just continue to sail as far as we can on this really scuffed boat, and let's hope we make it far. Let's say hypothetically you lost your boat and now you're stranded. Make sure to jump to the nearest land like a reasonable person would do and walk to the black borders. But if you think you can make it without dying on the water, you could actually jump, because the water is actually a conveyor. It moves at 12 steps per second, whereas walking moves at 16. So if you were to jump and stand on the water, you might go around 28 steps per second, which is pretty fast. Let me just show you right here. I'm going to prove that you could jump to a black border. And if you have a perk like a mega member, you actually get plus 300 HP, so you can make it farther by jumping. You're going to require another person because this requires you to turn on PvP mode, and you can actually earn some gold in PvP mode. Just go to settings and turn it on. So the thing is, you could kill anyone and you get 3 gold, like if you grab some weapons here. Got the flintlock key right here. If you just shoot someone and one-shot them, you would actually get 3 gold. But if you want to be more efficient, you could get a cannon. Let me see if I could find the cannon. It's right over here. If you use a cannon like this and you kill them, you would actually get 10 gold instead. So you could have one person who has PvP mode AFK in here. May it be your account or one of your friends that lets you grind, farm them. You can actually use 2 cannons and just keep blasting them. You get 10 gold for each kill, so you could just rack up gold pretty quickly. It might be faster than you sailing, so you could try that if you want. Here's the last method. So depends on what server you're in or do you have friends or not. What you could do is you could join different teams and you could get carried by people. Let's say you're a complete noob. Your boat looks something like this. Let me just build a quick noob boat a little bit. I remember it being 6 blocks and 1 chair as a default. So let's say this is your boat. You obviously are not going to get very far. So what you could do is, let's say you have a friend that loads in a boat. Now let me just load in a boat. Pretend that this is somebody else. But if you find somebody else with like a decently sized boat, maybe not this big, because they probably won't let anyone on if they have a boat this big. Just find some intermediate people and just hop on the board their boat and sail with them. This will actually give you better results as members get 10 gold for Black Mall, instead of being a leader, they only get 8. If you have some friends, you can make them carry you, or if you could find random people to carry you. So that's another money making method. This method I personally used when I was starting out and stuff, so you could use this if you want. It's not that bad. Before I end the video, you could actually get some codes to redeem. Just look up BAFT Wiki and look up the codes that are valid. I redeemed most of the codes, well, except high. So I just got 5 gold for some reason. Some codes will actually give you a bit decent amount. So just watch out for codes on the wiki. That one I redeemed, so you can only redeem them once. This might be helpful if you're new. Some of them will give you up to like 500 gold, I remember, in a code like that. But anyways, this is the end of the video. If you like, subscribe, and see you guys next time.